There was no clear-cut blueprint for success early on in ACC play. The league was a jumbled mess. But eventually, two teams separated themselves from the pack. And tonight, here at College Park, it'll be a battle for first place. Maryland, led by Player of the Year candidate Gravis Vasquez on his senior night, takes aim at first place Duke, led by John Shire. Two really good basketball teams that are going to meet here tonight. As we check the ACC standings for you, you can see that Duke and Maryland have separated themselves from the pack, and each has only one regular season game remaining after this one here tonight. Dan Shulman and Jay Billis, this building is fired up for this game. What does it mean?
Well, number one seed is on the line. The ACC championship, you get to hang a banner for the regular season, and the fan bases hate each other, which is not insignificant as well.
You do get kind of a subtle anti-Duke vibe when you walk into the building here tonight. Let's take a look at kind of a modified star watch. We've maybe got the top two candidates for ACC Player of the Year in the building tonight, beginning with John Shire.
I think ACC Player of the Year could very well be decided in this game, and John Shire has been Mr. Everything for Duke. He handles the ball. He distributes it. He's an outstanding scorer, and he is also a very good defender.
The starting lineup for the Duke Blue Devils, Shire joined, of course, by Nolan Smith, Kyle Singler, Lance Thomas, and Brian Zubek, who had a breakout game a few weeks ago against Maryland. Now, the other leading contender for ACC Player of the Year, of course, is Maryland's Gravis Vasquez.
Well, Gravis Vasquez is one of the all-time greats here at Maryland, the only player in ACC history to have scored 2,000 points, 700 assists, and 600 rebounds. He is Mr. Everything to Maryland and their emotional leader as well.
He is joined by two other seniors here on senior night, and Eric Hayes and Landon Milbourne, also Sean Mosley, and a very talented freshman in Jordan Williams. Well, as you can hear, as you can feel, it is alive here for the Comcast Center. This place doesn't take a backseat to anywhere in terms of the emotion, especially when Duke is here. Aaron Anders, this must have been a tough ticket.
Certainly was, Dan. The lower level alone going anywhere from $200 to $700 on the internet. A great story that was famous here in the local paper this week. A first-year law student advertised on Craigslist. He couldn't afford a ticket, so in exchange, he would give a to-be-determined certain number of hours if he passes the Maryland bar for a seat in the House tonight. The athletic director, Debbie Yao, got that request. She got him a ticket in the House tonight. I just want to know from Jay Billis, the lawyer, is that worth it?
You never give away your services for free, Aaron. No self-respecting lawyer would ever do that.
Although you probably got some pretty good offers for this seat right here in center court tonight. You and I and Aaron, we're three of the luckiest people in this building tonight. This is going to be fun. Duke, a game up on Maryland for the lead in the ACC. They beat Maryland easily at Cameron 3 weeks ago. The Terps hoping to exact a measure of revenge here tonight. A win by Duke. They clinch outright the regular season title. A win by Maryland. They tie Duke for first place with a game to go. Eric Hayes strikes first.
And right away, Nolan Smith guarding Gravis Vasquez, and a terrific back cut by Eric Hayes. A 2-2-1 three-quarter court pressure by Maryland.
A couple of very experienced teams. So rare, Jay, to see two teams at this level starting so many seniors and juniors.
No question. And that experience is going to be very important, especially on the glass. Maryland has to keep Duke off the offensive glass.
Shire runs down the offensive rebound. Nolan Smith wide open, and he leaves the three short. This is Vasquez coming off a 41-point game at Virginia Tech in a double overtime win on the weekend. Given his ability, his personality, and it's senior night, is there a danger he comes out a little bit too emotional tonight?
There is a great danger of that. You always worry about how a player's going to handle it. Great block by Jordan Williams.
Numbers for Maryland. Great pass. And a missed opportunity by Mosley on the layup, and we've got a foul going against the Terps.
Already this game incredibly physical.
Mike Krzyzewski, the Hall of Famer, the winningest active coach, looking for another ACC regular season title. Gary Williams, a probable future Hall of Famer and fifth among all active coaches with 646 wins. Ironically, when Duke beat Maryland 3 weeks ago, it was on Mike Krzyzewski's birthday. Tomorrow is Gary Williams' 65th birthday. He'll celebrate a lot more tonight if they can come up with a win over the Blue Devils.
Maryland, a team that likes to put on full court pressure. They want to speed the game and make you make decisions at a higher speed.
If you look at conference stats, it is Maryland leading in the most offensive categories, including scoring, field goal percentage, assists, three-point percentage. They're a very good offensive team. Vasquez into traffic, and he draws the foul.
Maryland has very good guards. The key for Maryland, two things. They have got to keep Duke off the offensive glass. Maryland's first shot defense is good, but they give up a lot of second shots, especially against a good offensive rebounding team like Duke. And Maryland's got to guard that three-point line. Duke is an outstanding defensive team, especially guarding that line. Maryland has to match that ability and not give Duke some open three-point shots.
At the line is Gravis Vasquez. You see his numbers on the season. Second in the league in scoring, leads the league in assists, is number three on Maryland's all-time scoring list, will likely finish second, an outside shot at finishing first. Get into that more a little bit later. And he's second all-time to Steve Blake in assists. This guy, at times, up and down, Jay, but if you look at the body of work over 4 years, a remarkable career.
I think he's going to have his jersey retired. That's how important he has been to this university. He's been the face of the team for the last 4 years. He's really been its heart and soul.
And I thought he was going to bear hug Gary Williams right off the court during the senior night ceremony before the game. Duke 0 for 4 in the first couple of minutes.
Duke's going to run a lot of ball screens. They probably get 80% of their offense off of ball screens and offensive rebounds.
Shire gets a look in the corner, and he's missed his first 2 3-pointers. Maryland looking to push. Vasquez for three. What a start for the Terps.
Got to give a lot of credit to Sean Mosley, not only for the rebound, but the great outlet pass to start that break. Maryland right now not even guarding Lance Thomas out on the perimeter. They're trying to help out.
Shire to Zubek, who follows it in. Zubek has 16 points and 17 rebounds in the win over Maryland 3 weeks ago. Mosley misses the three, and a foul on Kyle Singler.
Sean Mosley is not a big player. He is 6'4", a power guard, but he will stick his nose in there and go after the ball, and you've got to send all five guys to the defensive glass, but that outlet pass was outstanding by Mosley. That started it all out.
Hayes off to Vasquez. Hayes can do a lot of the ball handling as well, averaging about 4 assists per game. Landon Milbourne, another one of the seniors, and he strikes with a three.
Vasquez, so good off of ball screens. He doesn't blast off them, but when he comes off, his vision is so good. That little pick and pop is really difficult to guard because Milburn can space the floor.
Shire, a long two-pointer, and he's pulled early. No-look pass. Vasquez off to Mosley. Baseline Milbourne, and a foul. Going against Milbourne, called for the charge.
Maryland using this wing ball screen, a little UCLA cut, then the wing ball screen. And Milburn goes one way, then goes the other. Was a little bit confused, but was smart enough to adjust to get to the open area. And Vasquez, who's got extraordinary vision with the basketball. You know, Bob Knight says it all the time. Some players look, other players see. And Gravis Vasquez is one of those players that sees.
Milburn just picked up his second foul, so he's gone to the bench. Dino Gregory has checked into the game. Now there's something wrong with one of the baskets. Now with the net to our left, as you can see, The net is torn in one spot, so they're going to have to replace the net, Jay. How often do you see this?
Well, the ball only went through that net one time, so. Must have been a burner.
Yeah, Brian Zubek with that power follow that tore the net a little bit.
I'll tell you, Zubek has really improved this year. He's slowed down. He is using his size. And over the last five or six games, he has been a tremendous asset to Duke.
Here is the basket, and we'll see if this is when it happened.
Yeah, it
looks like maybe Milburn got a finger in there.
Yeah, Landon Milburn got his hand caught in there, but Zubek did a nice job of, one, catching that ball. That catch was not an easy one, and he kept the ball high.
We'll step aside while they sort this out. A great start for Maryland here tonight.
Once there was a sad stretch of road where drivers just couldn't stop in time. But along came the Michelin man who reminded them the right tire changes everything. With better tires in place, that sad stretch of road wasn't so sad anymore. Michelin HydroEdge tires stop up to 14 feet shorter. Michelin, a better way forward.
Chris Vasquez gets here. He plays hard every game.
He brings so much emotion to this school. It's unbelievable.
Well, a lot of people say that he's maybe obnoxious, but I don't have a problem with him.
I think that if I didn't go to this school, I would probably hate him.
Sometimes leaders have to be dramatic, and I think that he inspires his teammates.
If we keep winning games, he can be as loud as he wants.
And he is certainly backing up his emotion, his enthusiasm with his play. 19.5 points per game on the season in his last eight games, Jay, over 24 points per game. His numbers have gone up and up and up the deeper into the season that he plays. Mom and dad are here from Venezuela for senior night. Obviously a very emotional experience for them. Landon Milburn and also Eric Hayes, also part of the senior night festivities here. And here's Vasquez coming out.
Well, yesterday, Gravis Vasquez was talking about how he had no words to describe how he feels about Maryland and what this four-year period has meant in his life. And he plays for a very emotional coach in Gary Williams, and those two have fed off each other.
They continue to, for lack of a better term, as Jake told me during the break, cut down the nets here at the Comcast Center.
Oh, and this one is tied up. Time off Boston.
Man, I wish this game would never end. Hey, send it into overtime. Yeah.
No problem.
Boston's going to get one last chance. It's the pass up to Hampton for the win. Oh, he loses control. This one is going into overtime.
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here. As a bounty hunter, Milo's work was a nightmare, but it's about to become his dream job.
You're telling me that I'll get $5,000 to go pick up my ex-wife and bring her to jail?
You're a bounty hunter.
No!
I won't even break a sweat.
On March 19th, get some action. Jennifer Aniston, Gerard Butler.
Where do you think you're going?
The Bounty Hunter.
Hey, you trying to seduce me?
Yeah.
What's the hottest thing about me? Your gun.
Rated PG-13.
To all the happiness and luck that life can hold, and at the end of your rainbow, a pot of gold. Happy St. Paddy's Day from Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness.
So what's the problem?
It's your blades, pal.
Oh, man, I should have known.
Even the best blades get worn down. When that happens, it's not as comfortable, see? When the strip turns white, you should think about changing it for a smoother ride.
Gillette Fusion. Fresh blade, more comfortable shave.
Syracuse battles Louisville, then UNC clashes with Duke, Saturday on ESPN.
A little bit of a bubble game, Wake Forest and Florida State. Both teams currently in, according to ESPN's Bracketology, one a 10 seed, the other an 8 seed. And down two, Wake had it, lost it, got it back, tied up. And the possession arrow pointed to FSU, and they hang on and win 51-47. That big showdown, Kansas-Kansas State, they've gone to the half. Kansas up by 7. You see that Sherron Collins has 8. Xavier Henry's carried him. Kentucky killing Georgia 52-36.
Carl, thank you. Back here at College Park, they continue to work on the net that was ripped inadvertently by Landon Milburn. They have cut it down. They've taken it out, putting the new one in. Here are the up-to-date ACC standings after the Virginia Tech win over NC State tonight, the Florida State win over Wake Forest, which is struggling right now. At this moment, according to our bracketologist, Joe Lenardi, he's got seven ACC teams in the NCAA tournament. What do you think?
I don't disagree with that. I think when you look at teams like Wake Forest and Georgia Tech, which traditionally might have a problem when we get to Selection Sunday, given the way they're finishing up the season, this year you're saying, well, if not them, then who?
Right.
I mean, this may be the weakest pool of at-large teams we've seen since they went to 64 teams in 1985. There are some good teams out there, but there are not a ton of them that are going to be competing successfully for those last few spots. I think it's going to be an easy job for the committee once we get down to the last spots.
Of course, we're watching a Duke team that is looking quite possibly at a number one seed. Maryland looking for a good seed as well, as they have won five in a row, playing their best basketball right now. Saturday night, ESPN, more Duke there at Cameron Indoor Stadium. It's the next installment of the UNC-Duke Tobacco Road rivalry. Number four, Duke against Carolina, which is starting to play some better basketball. Saturday primetime, presented by DirecTV on ESPN, Saturday at 9, before the game patch. College game day, driven by State Farm at 8. Does this delay, Jay, hurt Maryland because of the start they had in this game?
Yeah, it takes a little bit of momentum away, but I don't think it should be a big deal. I think this building can explode again if Maryland continues to play as well as they've played to start. Duke started off this game 1 of 8 from the field, that one being a putback by Brian Zubek. And Maryland going with that 1-2-1-1 three-quarter court pressure. They're going to try to keep the pressure on, slow the advance.
A 10-2 start on senior night here for Maryland, and a very good start for their star, Gravis Vasquez. Duke breaks the pressure easily.
Break the pressure, but they didn't really break it to score, and I think you have to do that.
Singler with a three. There was a time earlier this season when people were wondering what's going on, but Singler wasn't quite playing as well as was predicted. Remember, he had that wrist injury in the Wake Forest game, but Jay, he seems to be back at the top of his game.
Well, I think that 30-point game he had against Georgia Tech really busted him out of that mini slump that he was in. He shot the ball much better in the last 8 games.
Jordan Williams, the freshman, about 6'9", 260, and averaging double-figure rebounds his last 5 games. Vasquez frees himself, a little strong on the three. Rebound Gregory.
Duke defended that ball screen pretty well, but then just left the ball.
John Mosley coming off a couple of big scoring games. 37 points in his last 2 after being in single digits in each of his prior 8 games. So they've got some weapons. It's not just Vasquez. Nice pass to the cutting Haynes for the reverse.
Well, not only the pass, but the use of the left hand on the other side of the basket. What a spectacular play.
Even in his senior night introduction, Eric Hayes was introduced as he has quietly had a great career here at Maryland, and I guess that's the truth.
Understated in his impact on the game, but an outstanding shooter. When Eric Hayes is open, he drills it.
Floater left short by Smith. Loose ball rebound to the Terps, and they got numbers. Vasquez to Williams, and a foul.
Gravis Vasquez with the vision to see behind him. And Jordan Williams does a magnificent job of running the court. That's the way you finish a play.
What a start for the Terrapins here against Duke. Subs coming in. Both Plumlee brothers have come in. Miles and Mason, as Zubek and Thomas go out. Williams, not a good free throw shooter. That'll work. Not the way they teach you to do it, but it'll count. Where does this rank, Jay, as far as you're concerned in terms of hostile road environments in the ACC?
It's right up at the top. I think if you can get a win here against Maryland, you know you've handled the gauntlet.
Maryland's only been beaten once here all season as Miles Plumlee makes a basket, and that basket gets hung up on the rim, but it's okay. Their only loss in this building this year to William and Mary back in non-conference play.
Watch this pass. A great cut by Eric Hayes, and what a tremendous finish with that left hand.
Trap on Vasquez. He gets out of it. Couldn't get out of that one. Shire and Vasquez, the two ACC Player of the Year candidates, covering each other tonight. Great rebound by Hayes, and look at the numbers for Maryland again. Cliff Tucker with a basket.
The big guys for Duke are not running the floor as hard as the bigs for Maryland. Thus far in the game, Maryland has been sprinting the court. Duke has been running it.
Singler, Miles Plumlee open again. Not this time. Over the back foul, Mason Plumlee. Let's bring in Aaron Andrews.
Dan, you guys were just talking about the Comcast Center, how this place is going bananas, and talking to Duke coaches and players this afternoon, they said their number one key is just poise. Chris Collins was saying, you know, this Maryland team is going to go on runs, but they know what to expect out of this Maryland crowd. They're hearing it. So are you guys, I'm sure, right behind those or in front of those students.
No question, right behind us, and also the student wall off to our right. That end of the arena built at a steeper incline to bring everybody closer to the court. Cliff Tucker again.
Now, Cliff Tucker is a very good driver. But you need to force him left. That's exactly what Singler did. But in doing that, he gave up middle. And Tucker made a very difficult shot.
Tucker, the guy who hit that game-winning three against Georgia Tech at the buzzer a couple of weeks ago. Mason Plumlee is fouled. Well, it's never easy on the road, although Duke has been playing much better on the road lately. They are 5-4 overall, but they didn't win a game on the road until the win at Clemson. The game day game back in January, you can see, especially offensively, it's been a much different story for them in a true road game.
As it is for most teams, but if Duke were able to win this game, they'd be the only team in the ACC with a winning road record.
Andre Dawkins into the game for Duke. And James Padgett will check in and give Jordan Williams a breather for Maryland.
Now, Aaron's point about poise was a really important one. And the one place on the road where you really need to show poise is on the offensive end. Because she's right. Maryland's going to go on runs, so Duke has to be poised and make sure that they're efficient offensively to match Maryland's scoring. This is an outstanding offensive team, the Terps.
Good box out there, but a bad pass. Padgett threw it away. Shire. And Maryland's got it. Another Duke turnover. Duke has defeated the Terps six times in a row, including three times last year, and once handily at Cameron Indoor Stadium 3 weeks ago, 77-56. Vasquez, tough shot.
Gravis Vasquez isn't just going to blow by you. He's going to use craftiness to do it. In a game of 5-on-5, he's as good as anybody in the country.
7 points, 3 assists already for Vasquez on his senior night. And a push in the back there, a foul on Dino Gregory. To a timeout we go, Jay. And so far, Gravis Vasquez really delivering tonight.
Well, Gravis Vasquez just knows how to play, and Gary Williams trusts him implicitly.
Hey, I was just in town for a few days, and I was wondering if I could say hi to the doctor. Is he in?
He's in Copenhagen.
Oh, well, that's nice.
So you can still see him?
You just said he was in
Copenhagen. Come on.
It's pretty far.
Doc, look who's in town.
Ellen.
Copenhagen?
Cool, right? Vacation.
But still seeing patients. Workaholic.
I heard that.
She said it.
The new office. See it, live it, share it. On the Human Network. Cisco.
To all the happiness and luck that life can hold, and at the end of your rainbow, a pot of gold. Happy St. Paddy's Day from Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness.
All we ask is that you keep doing what you've always done. The Lexus RX. Never has a vehicle been designed to feel so natural.
To all the happiness and luck that life can hold, and at the end of your rainbow, a pot of gold. Happy St. Paddy's Day from Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness.
A big halftime report coming up, but before we get there, we still have to conclude our first half. Get you some highlights of Kansas State and Kansas, 5-2. First time since 61, they've been ranked in the top five, each of them. Woo! Denny Clemente bangs down a three. He's got 11. Poland's got 17. It's 45 all on ESPN360.com.
Well, if Kansas State can pull off that win, what an accomplishment that would be for them. As we take a look at the top 10, most people, Jay, feel that Syracuse, Kansas, Kentucky are assured of number one seeds. Who do you think is the best bet to get the fourth number one?
I think right now it's Duke, because they've won 9 games against the top 50. That's the most of anybody in the country. So I think Duke is in a very good position, but there's still a fair ways to go. You've got one last game after this in the regular season and then conference tournaments.
Purdue, by the way, with a win over Indiana tonight. Without Robbie Hummel, the big ovation you hear is a shot of Juan Dixon, the former Maryland star. And Maryland's all-time leading scorer, incidentally, who is here at the game tonight. He was part of a national championship team back in 2002, along with Steve Blake, Lonnie Baxter, Chris Wilcox, and others. Andre Dawkins misses the three. A very effective score for them earlier this season, a much lesser role in conference play. Padgett can't handle the pass. And there's Juan Dixon.
The all-time leading scorer here at Maryland, led him to the national championship in 2002, Final Four in 2001. And never forget the first time I saw Juan Dixon. He was redshirting. I was at a Maryland practice. And I looked over and I said to Gary Williams, "Who's that little skinny kid over there?" And he said, "That's Juan Dixon." And he said, "He's going to be as good as Johnny Dawkins was at Duke."
Wow.
And he was right.
He was right. His brother Jermaine Dixon, now a player with Pittsburgh. At the moment, Vasquez, Gravis Vasquez, is 193 points behind Juan Dixon for the all-time scoring record here at Maryland. John Shire with a driving layup.
Now, Gravis Vasquez has done a pretty darn good job on John Shire, because he's been chasing him off of that three-point line. Vasquez has got the size to really bother Shire, which is a very difficult thing. It's hard to speed Shire up. He plays at his own pace and makes plays on the floor. He's an outstanding playmaker.
There's a very low percentage shot taken there by Vasquez. Gregory looked like he might have gotten fouled on the way up there. And now we've got a held ball. The arrow will give it to Duke.
Maryland really fighting Duke on the glass at both ends, and that's what they need to do to stay competitive in this game.
Here are your top three scorers all time in Maryland history, including the points for Vasquez tonight. He's got a shot at Dixon, but Maryland would have to have a pretty good run both in the ACC tournament and in the NCAA tournament. He would probably need, the way he's been going lately, 7 or 8 games in order to challenge that record. Maybe even more than that.
Just a remarkable career with all the different things that he has done. You just don't see players getting triple doubles and 41 points in a game on the road.
The triple double you're speaking of was last year against the eventual national champion North Carolina. 35 points, 11 rebounds, and 10 assists. An incredible night for Vasquez as Kyle Singler knocks one down.
Smart play by Singler to take Tucker down into the low post, where he's got a length advantage.
Smith now on to Vasquez. Tucker from the elbow, and it rolls off the rim, but it stays with Maryland.
I give a lot of credit there to Lance Thomas defensively. He was right there off that curl and stopped the forward progress of Tucker and made him take a difficult shot.
Now things have changed from what they could have been for Duke. Thomas with a bone bruise in his knee in the game against Carolina. Looked like he was going to be more serious, but he kept playing. Brian Zubek becoming a starter, and really the last couple of weeks, Jay, playing the best basketball of his 4-year career.
Well, with Zubek in the lineup, even though he hasn't played a lot of minutes in his career, that gives Duke a very experienced first five.
Baseline jumper is there for Dino Gregory, junior out of Baltimore. Nice move by Smith, and the floater goes. That was beautiful.
have to find Duke's guards in transition. The big three of Shire, Smith, and Singler. And they get the ball down court quickly and set up at that line. They are unafraid to pull the trigger. Bowie.
And he got fouled.
Well, that's a bit of a bailout foul. You've got to be more disciplined defensively. Bowie didn't have anything to do with that ball once he left the floor. And when you foul, you bail him
out. Second foul on Lance Thomas. So he's going to check out. Mason Plumlee's coming back in. And Gravis Vasquez has returned now for
Maryland. Returning from Duke, number five, Mason Plumlee.
The inbounds, he finds Gregory. Mosley. Nicely done. Great unselfish basketball early tonight by the Terps.
And a really good pass by Vasquez, looking for the man that set the screen rather than the cutter coming off of it. And Gregory did not panic when he turned and saw Duke's defense all over him.
Jordan Williams called for the foul. Trying to defend Zubek. Coverage of men's college basketball continues on ESPN Saturday afternoon with a great doubleheader. It'll be the number one team in the nation, the Syracuse Orange, taking on Louisville. The Cardinals have already beaten the Orange this year. And then Texas against Baylor, the Longhorns, Jay. They've got to figure it out very soon. They have been plummeting the last few weeks.
Yeah, they have really struggled to score. And they have certainly had their share of injuries in the backcourt. And maybe the biggest one was losing Varez Ward early on in the season.
Doge Balde out as well for the year. Nolan Smith knocks down a three. And that net gets hung up again. Over that net ever since the game began.
Well, that gives Duke a little bit of time to get back and not have to face transition offense after a made field goal. Boy, it is so hard when you play Duke. You can't help off those shooters.
Gravis Vasquez called for the offensive foul. Zubek takes the charge.
That was a good call, just nowhere for Vasquez to go. And that's not something he needed to do. He decided to take him on instead of just crossing over and splitting the defenders to get to the rim. He had the angle to get to the rim.
Singler off the screen, traveled.
That's what Aaron Andrews was talking about before, having the poise to execute. The floor was spread. Singler had an opening and just walked with it.
So Maryland with the ball and an 8-point lead. 8 minutes and change to go here in the first half at the Comcast Center. Zubek called for the foul.
Maryland just running their flex offense there. The cutter went low. That allows the postman to roll back. But the ball wasn't at an angle. There was no need to foul.
Both teams, Jay, with 16 fouls. So the next one either way will put the other team in the bonus. Vasquez in that game against Virginia Tech in the weekend already scored 41, scored 28 of them in the second half. The game went double overtime. Misses that three. And the rebound comes down to the Blue Devils, and they look to run a little bit.
Maryland been settling for jump shots. They have to keep running offense. They didn't do that down at Duke. They got away from running their offense. They let the pressure, especially on the ball, get to them a bit.
Shire. Good rebound by Gregory, but he lost it off to Nolan Smith. And Zubek is there to clean it up.
Well, that's the offensive board work that we talked about at the beginning of the game. Mason Plumlee kept that ball alive, went up with both hands and went right over the top. Maryland not big enough and couldn't move him out of there.
Mosley strong enough to take a bump and still knock down the shot.
Mosley's been playing very well over his last two games. He's came into this game in the last two, averaging 18 and a half points. He was 12 of his last 16.
Good ball pressure by Mosley on Singler. Shire driving. Zubek. Rebound Williams of the Terps. Hayden steps into a three. Zubek injured. Gary Williams fired up as always in this big game here at the Comcast Center as Maryland tries to move into a first place tie in the ACC with the Blue Devils.
My team deserves a race.
You've only been here a week.
Not even.
With an A-plus credit rating in good times and bad, Sun Life Financial should be famous.
We're working on it.
So you're seriously proposing we change our name to Sun Life Valley?
Do we still get to go skiing?
Sooner or later, you'll know our name. Sun Life Financial.
I see you have the Verizon network.
Yeah.
You know, if you had AT&T, you'd have the nation's fastest 3G network. And you'd be able to download songs faster, download videos faster, and you could talk and surf the web at the same time. You got a little map in your suit.
When you compare, there's no comparison. AT&T, a better 3G experience. Buy any smartphone after mail-in rebate and get any messaging phone free after mail-in rebate.
It's another perfect day out here today.
Can I get you anything else?
We gotta get back to work.
We even saw a kid taking a bath in a water fountain. Whoop, I spoke too soon. This just in, a freak storm is blowing into the area. We're going to be experiencing hurricane-force winds and dense fog. Sheets of driving spray. Stay inside, hunker down, grab a beer. This is going to be a long one.
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here.
We're receiving reports of hail the size of... Oh, boy.
Over 16,000 strong at the fog watching this one, Kansas and Kansas State. Tyrell Reed is going to spot up for a three and drain it. And only one of two from the field in the last game, but he's doing all right. Poland still got 17. Kansas was tied. Now they begin to pull away. Kentucky over Georgia, big, with 7-plus to go. Mississippi State struggling against Auburn in the second. Another ESPN 360 pair right there.
Carl, back here at the Comcast Center, an 11-point lead for Maryland over Duke and a Duke injury as well. Jay, what happened to Brian Zubek?
Well, Zubek went up for this offensive rebound and looked like he dislocated a finger when we first looked at it. Seems that's been confirmed. Zubek has been the best rebounder in this game for Duke. He's got four rebounds, two of them on the offensive end. Their only other offensive rebound came from Shire on the very first play of the game.
And we're told that Zubek will return to the game possibly later on. Right now it's the Plumlee brothers in there in the front court for the Blue Devils, who Jay are getting manhandled on the glass by the Terps so far tonight. Air ball by Smith. That's something he's going to hear about the rest of the night. Mosley for three. Four threes already and eight attempts for Maryland, and this is their biggest lead of the game.
Transition defense, both after a make and a miss, has been killing Duke. Maryland has taken advantage of Duke's inability to build out its defense.
Miles Plumlee will knock down a three. That is the first three he has attempted this year. And that stops an 8-0 run for the Terps. Good trap on Vasquez. Fortunate to find Williams, who is fouled.
That was a very dangerous pass. Surprising that it went through, but Kyle Singler not coming out with a hand up on a three-point shooter. And John Mosley, not known as a great three-point shooter, but hits about 45% because he takes good shots and he takes shots stepping into them.
The line now for the Terps, one of the leading contenders. We talked about player of the year. This is one of the leading contenders for the rookie of the year in the ACC. Jordan Williams, what do you like about his game?
Well, he really rebounds. You know, he's an old school big guy that parks himself down in the post and he works. And he's got to fix his shooting motion for free throws. He's got a little flaw in his shooting motion. He keeps that left shoulder back. He needs to move it back up so he's got more consistency.
Miles Plumlee over the back with the foul.
Maryland has done a great job on the glass to this point in the game. They have sent all five guys to the defensive glass. They're rebounding with both hands. For the most part, they have blocked out. Gary Williams spent a lot of time yesterday in practice and in film session talking about the importance of getting on the glass.
So the graphic there, Maryland more than doubling Duke, 18-8 in the rebounding department so far. And we talk about teams having the spirit of their coach, Jay, and I don't know that that's more true anywhere than at Maryland. Gary Williams is as tough as they come, and his players seem to thrive on that chip on your shoulder underdog kind of mentality. Foul hard, and Nolan Smith will go to the line. Gary Williams seems to almost like being the underdog, and his players reflect that.
Well, in this league, in the ACC, there's been Dean Smith, Mike Krzyzewski, and Gary Williams. Those are the three most accomplished and best coaches that have been in this league. Now, Roy Williams is in that discussion as well, but he's only been in the league for a few years now, and he's accomplished a great deal in that short time.
Potential Hall of Famer?
No question. He should be in now, frankly. Well, what a move by Nolan Smith to get to the basket there. That crossover was outstanding, and he left Grievous Vasquez just standing there.
Smith up to seven, coming off a game in which he was held in single digits against Virginia on the week. And the big three for Duke accounting for about 53, 54 points per game. The second highest scoring trio in America behind only a trio at Notre Dame, which picked up another win tonight against Connecticut. How about this move by Hayes?
Now, Hayes is such a good cutter. When there's motion going one way, he will often cut against the grain and find an opening. He's got four or five rebounds in this game. He's made a couple of good passes. He's knocked down his open shots.
Dawkins runs down the air and pass, hits the deck. And eventually we're going to hail the ball and the arrow, giving it to the Terps. Gary Williams loves that.
And James Padgett, who threw a ball away earlier in this ball game, getting on the floor. You don't always see freshmen doing that. He played at Lincoln High School in Brooklyn in New York. The same high school that produced Sebastian Telfair. He played with Lance Stevenson, a freshman at Cincinnati.
Saturday night. It'll be Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV. We'll be at Cameron Indoor Stadium at Duke for senior night there. And North Carolina against number four Duke. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV. Before the game, catch College Game Day driven by State Farm at 8 Eastern. So it's senior night here at a College Park. Senior night Saturday night there for Shire, Zubek, and Thomas. Hayes, tough fadeaway. Great weak side rebound by Lance Thomas.
You don't usually see Eric Hayes take tough shots like that. Usually he finds an opening. And when he has a little bit of space, pulls the trigger on a good one.
It's the first miss that he's had tonight. He's got 9 points and five rebounds already.
That's a nice job by Mosley to stay low when guarding single.
Dawkins into Thomas for the jump hook. John Shire's been on the bench for a while for Duke, and he normally plays 37 to 38 minutes a game.
Lance Thomas has been a nice lift. Dawkins fell asleep.
Shire, if you're wondering, just one foul, but only one for six from the floor. They work on that dislocated finger of Zubek. Maryland up by 10.
At Hyundai, we believe that a safety feature like electronic stability control is too important to charge a premium for. But we're not alone. The government thinks it's important too. And that's why by 2012, every new vehicle sold will be mandated to have a safety feature that's already standard on a 2010 Tucson today. Do you really want to wait?
This summer, 31 countries will fall
and one will be crowned champion. Live from South Africa, the 2010 FIFA World Cup on ESPN, coming in June.
All we ask is that you keep doing what you've always done. The Lexus RX. Never has a vehicle been designed to feel so natural.
To survive in the big dance, you can't study just one team at a time. You've got to be ready for anything. I prepare my team with NCAA Mega March Madness, only on DirecTV. It's the only way to watch every tournament game in HD. Can't do it with cable. Can't do it with Dish. And with four live games all on one channel, you won't have to find the upsets. They'll find you.
Watch every tournament game with NCAA Mega March Madness, only on DirecTV.
Steve Lab has been crunching the numbers. Can't wait to see what he's got for us on the UPS Halftime Report. I know this, the numbers added up to nothing for that guy. Al Farouk Aminu, first time in his career. Lucky Irish, unlucky UConn. We'll review that Big East clash, if you will. And K-State and KU on Sharon Collins Senior Night. We'll find out how the Jayhawks, woo, are muscling up against K-State. That's at the half.
All right, and welcome back to College Park, and you can see an update on the two Player of the Year candidates in the ACC, John Shire, Gravis Vasquez. By the way, we are told that an earlier foul that was originally given to Mason Plumlee was switched to John Shire. So Shire has two fouls, just one for six, 2 points, two fouls. He is back in the game now, though, with 3:23 left in the first half. Vasquez getting ready to check in.
Vasquez has been guarding Shire when he's been in the ballgame, and his size has bothered Shire a bit.
Mosley knocks down a pair and heads to the bench for Vasquez. A 77-56 win for Duke over Maryland, February 13th at Cameron, in a game that was lopsided with the exception of about a four-minute stretch early in the second half when Maryland made a 10-0 run. But other than that, it was a one-sided affair.
Duke dominated the offensive glass in that ballgame. That has not been the case in this one.
Singler gets a great look and knocks down his second three of the game.
Duke's big guys set good screens. They can really get some openings and create some space for the shooters. Well, 1-2-2, half-court zone right now by Duke. Lance Thomas out front. That gives them a little bit more length.
How often do you see Coach K play zone?
Not a ton, but he has been using it. I think Jim Boeheim's influence on Mike Krzyzewski has brought zone a little more into play. Another great cut.
Good patience by Williams, too, on a great feed by Hayes.
Hayes is a great cutter. He sees openings and he takes advantage of them with strong cuts.
Good cut here by Singler. It'll count. Singler will have a chance for a three-point play.
A smart play by Singler. And Tucker not only left the floor on that shot fake, but he probably should have hammered Singler on the way down so as not to let him finish the play.
So Singler into double figures already here in the first half. And give him 11 right now. Duke back within 8.
Think about Kyle Singler. He may not always shoot the ball well, but he competes. He's one of those players that really relishes going on the road.
Duke has never led. Maryland has led by as many as 14. Good save there by Mosley. Hazel launched from the wing, missed the three. Rebound Zubek, who has returned with his hand, his fingers taped up on the left hand.
Well, one thing Maryland has to do if Duke stays in that zone, they've got to penetrate it off the dribble. You just can't throw the ball around the perimeter. You have got to dribble penetrate.
There's a size advantage at the small forward position for Singler. Good hands by Mosley, though. You got 6'4 guarding 6'8. Offensive foul, Zubek.
That's where Zubek just has to use his size. You know, to allow Singler to make a play, you can't just step in there and risk a player control foul and give up possession on the road.
Two on Zubek, two on Shire, two on Thomas. Maryland got out of the gate very quickly, was up 10-2, electrified the crowd, and they have continued to lead for the entire first half, but Duke has crept a little bit closer after being down by as many as 14. Smith for three, and they're back within five. Timeout, Gary Williams.
With a zone call really disrupted Maryland's rhythm on the offensive end.
Take a 30-second timeout.
You can see Nolan Smith coming off that screen and Eric Hayes just trailing way too late. You got to chase him off that three-point line, be right on that hip, and force him inside of the line.
Duke right now 12-2 in the ACC, Maryland 11-3. A win for Maryland, they'll move into a first-place tie each game, each team with a game remaining after this one. You can see the jump that Nolan Smith has made. From last year to this year, of course, the departure of Gerald Henderson, freeing up minutes and shots and so forth. And maybe there's even another jump coming for Nolan Smith next year when John Shire is gone.
Mike Krzyzewski was saying that at practice today, that he thinks that Smith is going to make an even bigger jump with his confidence in his play next season. He's more of an attack guard. He's not a true point guard. He's got to look to score. He's certainly done a great job of that this year.
Nice look inside from Hayes to Williams. And we've got a foul going against Duke, I believe. Or was it just out of bounds? Just out of bounds, it'll be Maryland the ball. One more note on the standings. If the two teams, if Maryland wins tonight, and the two teams, say, both win on the weekend and finish tied atop the ACC standings, they will share the regular season crown. Each could hoist a banner. But in all situations, Duke will win the tiebreaker, which means they would be the number one seed in the ACC tournament.
There's where Landon Milburn can struggle a little bit, is trying to score close to the basket over size.
Final minute of the first half. Shire. And just like that, it's a two-point game. What a run here for Duke at the end of the half.
Well, it's been the three-point line that's gotten Duke back into this on the offensive end, and it's been this 1-2-2 zone, or 3-2 zone, odd man front, whatever you want to call it, that has gotten Duke back in it on the defensive end.
There's the run, 12-2 in less than 3 minutes to make a game of it. And with a 1 second difference on the clock, Maryland will hold for the last shot.
Maryland's going to want to let this go with about 4 seconds left to give them an opportunity for an offensive rebound.
Mosley. And an air ball, shot clock violation. They might put a little bit more time back on the clock as they give the ball to Duke. Various people were getting ready to leave the floor at the end of the first half, but Duke's still going to get the ball here. I go to closer to maybe 1.8, Jay, than 0.8.
And Duke fortunate that they didn't get a foul there. Plumlee went out to contest that shot and probably got a little too close to Mosley when he was pulling the trigger on that.
More college basketball action coming your way Saturday afternoon here on ESPN. Men's college basketball presented by 5-Hour Energy, Syracuse and Louisville. Remember, the Cardinals beat the Orange up at the Carrier Dome just a couple of weeks ago. And then it'll be Texas and Baylor. Men's college basketball presented by 5-Hour Energy on ESPN Saturday. Louisville making a good case even before this game to get an at-large?
I think so, but they're close to the line. I wouldn't recommend losing more games if they could beat Syracuse at home. To have two wins over Syracuse would almost guarantee inclusion into the field.
No more time put back on the clock, just 0.8 for Duke. Singler to inbound. And the first half comes to a close with Duke closing on a 12-2 run, a 19-7 run over a longer period of time to go from 14 down to 2 down. They hit their last 4 three-pointers and are right back in the game. Aaron Andrews is with Gary Williams.
Dan, thanks so much. Gary, how did Duke get back in this?
Oh, they made some shots. They hit some really good shots. Plus, when they went zone, we didn't run very good offense. So it was a bad combination, but we've got a two-point lead.
What's the key in the second half to get back into this?
Well, we have to get back playing like we did earlier in the game. We have to have more enthusiasm and energy. So I think we still have it, so we'll see.
All right, Coach, thanks. All right, guys.
Well, certainly Coach Williams never lacks for enthusiasm and energy. We'll see how his players respond. Maryland by two at the break. Time now for the UPS Halftime Report with Carl Ravitch and Steve Lavin.
All right, Dan, Jay, Aaron, thank you very much. It's amazing just the tempo and how a game. I mean, Maryland is leading by two, but you almost feel like they're trailing by about 10. So well, you what know, happened?
Well, early, you're impressed, as we expected, by Vasquez and Hayes, a terrific tandem or a dynamic duo of guards at Gary Williams' disposal. And Vasquez feeling it both from distance as well as off the bounce and creating for his teammates. The emotional leader, fiery and passionate, playing more under control this year. In transition, scattered court, great time to shoot the three ball with Duke not organized defensively. And here, there's the razzle-dazzle to Williams, an outstanding freshman, I think one of the better freshmen in the ACC. So an explosive start, a big lead, double digits for Maryland, but give Duke credit, no surprise, they fight back with his own defense, something Mike Krzyzewski prefers not to play. It shows his flexibility and pliability, and of course the three ball by Singler and Shire catching late. Fire there in the second half.
Right, Singler really asserted themselves. So a two-point game, Maryland 40, Duke 38. Second half in just a bit. Let's get to some other key games going on tonight. Bubble game, if you will, although both teams began the night, according to ESPN Bracketology, already in the tournament, Wake Forest and FSU. So Michael Schneer, Solomon Alibi, Schneer track and a dunk. He had 14.
Well, the defense creates offense, gets Florida State out in transition where they excel.
Luke Laux, Xavier Gibson, a one-hand flush. He had 10.
I like the old-fashioned two-hand post feed down low.
Davidus Dulkees up with a steal on the inbounds and a layup. Wake turned it over 19 times. The stunning statistic in this whole game, Al-Farouq Aminu, first time in his career, no points.
A goose egg coming up empty and only two field goal attempts. That's something Dino Gaudio will address when he watches film. If they're going to have any chance to make a surge, they got to get the big fella the ball. Let the big dog eat. Aminu.
Big dog's probably hungry because he didn't eat anything in this one. So, FSU a winner. Vautech over NC State, 71-59. You see Virginia Tech's record, 22-7, 9-6, all during championship week. You'll get a chance to go over resumes. You'll hear more about teams in and out. You do on SportsCenter each and every morning, and you will during our championship week coverage. Lav and I will come back. Big game as far as the Big 12 goes, the Kansas Showdown. Frank Martin said biggest game, and maybe ever for K-State. On Senior Night for Sherron Collins.
NCAA March Madness better.
Papa's in the house!
With Papa John's $10 buzzer beater. All large pizzas just $10. Your choice of toppings. Your choice of pizzas. Even specialties just $10. Plus, get a free Coke Zero when you buy two 20-ounce Cokes online at PapaJohns.com.
You wrote the cheese, baby.
Let's eat. Get Papa John's $10 buzzer beater before time runs out.
Get to his house. He has 13 monkeys.
What? You know, there's something I've been wanting to tell you. I love you.
And I...
So cute. Another Miller Lite?
I'd love one. Thank you.
Do you love the taste of your beer this much? Well, you could. Try the great Pilsner taste of a triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness.
You're gorgeous. Look at you. I love you.
Skating, food should come at the push of a button.
So get ready for a seriously tasty burger.
With crinkle-cut pickles, thick cheese,
and did we mention 100% pure beef? It's a big and juicy burger delivered on roller skates from me.
Drive in today for a supersonic cheeseburger, and I'll give you a free medium order of tots. It's big. It's juicy.
It's Sonic.
On ESPN, number one Syracuse battles Louisville, presented by 5-Hour Energy. Then at 9, North Carolina clashes with 4th-ranked Duke, presented by DirecTV. This halftime report is delivered by UPS. Seize new opportunities at ups.com/whiteboard.
Right, last second to last game of the regular season for many teams, senior nights all across the country, as was the case at Fog Allen, Sharon Collins. Kansas up 57-47 with a pretty dish and a couple of passes around the rack, and Xavier Henry knocks it down.
Well, the playmaking, it all starts with Sharon Collins, then the quick hot potato, and Kansas getting down the floor in transition. Look at the sharing of the sugar. That's how you get it done for the high percentage look.
It sure was how you get it done for the high percentage look. Meantime, Collins, woo, watching that pretty drive, Taylor the finger roll. They were up 29-19 at that point. Now second half, Sharon, Xavier Henry ahead of the field with a flush.
How about the fly pattern? Throw it up to the big fella like a tight end.
And then Collins. Bang! 67-56. Kansas with a two-game lead in the conference, so K-State with a win needed some help if they wanted to tie for the conference title. It looks like it's not going to happen.
Sir Charles Barkley in the house.
One of the worst commercials on TV right now is a
Taco Bell.
Oh, it's awful. Off the turnover. Oh, Travis Leslie, fly me home. Georgia up four. Now Kentucky down six. John Wall steps in. There's no foul on this play. Oh! Oof.
Long, wiry build. The anticipation there.
KU down four. Darnell Dodson. Wildcats. Well, there's some serious arc. They're up two. Now John Wall. If you're backing up on defense, you're dead, right? Again?
Well, it's the beep beeper. A speed merchant can put the pedal to the metal as well as anybody in America and got the playmaking skills as well.
Wall 24 on 8 of 10, and they win 80-68.
I like the flex. Little weight room. Chest bump. Ooh.
Tennessee a winner, 80-73 over Arkansas. And Mississippi State sitting there at 21-8, 9-5 in conference, losing tonight to Auburn, 89-80. Not a good night for Mississippi State. They were not alone in having bad nights. Notre Dame and UConn, Jim Calhoun's team currently in, according to ESPN's bracketology. Notre Dame out. I think that changed after tonight. Torrey Jackson, the reverse lay-in. And Torrey Jackson, who scored 20 of his 22 in the second half, get out of town.
Well, and Notre Dame torching the nets against UConn, shooting 61% in the final 20 minutes of this game.
Notre Dame got Connecticut to check out of this game late in the second half. Jerome Dyson went 2 of 14 from the field. 58-50 is your final score. And check out some of the ugly numbers. Wednesday, 50 points. UConn averaging 72. This is a near must-win game for them.
Well, and frigid, anemic numbers here offensively up in South Bend for the Huskies.
Oh, just terrible. And you see there, field goal percentage was way, way down. Their three-point shooting was awful. But again, the body language, the effort to kind of reach defense without moving, that was symbolic of the whole game. And Notre Dame did it without Herangode.
Well, and unusual for a UConn Husky team. Jim Calhoun, throughout his career, has hung his hat on defense and on rebounding. And Notre Dame shooting 61%, torching the nets. Too many high percentage looks. No resistance at the rim defensively in terms of UConn's defense. And then 15 turnovers, the empty possessions as well, the anemic shooting numbers. So across the board here, UConn just throttled. Jim Calhoun won't be happy with it. It's at a point now for UConn to have any chance. They're going to need a miracle in the Big East tournament. They need to get Jerry McNamara come out of retirement. See if Jimmy Boeheim will lend him to UConn to see if he's got a miracle.
Is there any eligibility left?
Game. Maybe on a GI Bill. We'll have to see how far back he goes.
They're going to have to win about five games in the Big East Conference. And with the team they have and the way they're playing, not likely to happen at all. Purdue over Indiana, 74-55. Etuan Moore goes for 21-6. Nice little statement here without Robbie Hummel, obviously. And Wisconsin all over Iowa, 60-33 in the second.
Well, both these teams trying to send statements to the selection committee by having dominating performances. That's what you have to do at this stage of the year when you play the lower half in conference play. You got to throttle them.
Highlights coming up on College Game Night and then, of course, on SportsCenter as well. We'll come back. Williams may be the best freshman, according to some, in the conference. Looking very authoritative there. It's a two-point game.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. Seize new opportunities at ups.com/whiteboard.
All right, opportunity. Well, say you're looking for it in new places, like working with a supplier in China and a manufacturer in Germany to reach new customers in the U.S. Well, UPS can help bring it all together with efficient solutions like paperless invoice that can help make customs a breeze. Hey, the opportunities are out there. Seize them. with UPS. You know, it's hard drawing those perfect circles.
It's 40% off and more at Joseph A. Bank. Everything's at least 40% off. Plus, all suits and sport coats, 50% off. And your second, 70% off. Suits, sport coats, blazers. Your first, 50% off. Your second, 70% off. And everything else, 40% off at Joseph A. Bank.
There aren't many of us who use a cell phone just to make phone calls. But when AT&T or Verizon offer you an unlimited plan for $69.99, that's all it's good for, phone calls. With Sprint, for the same price, you get unlimited text, unlimited web, and unlimited calling to every mobile phone in America. Now that's more like it.
$69.99 for unlimited text, web, and calling to any mobile in America, only from Sprint.
Let's go, Bron. One shot.
For every tick of the clock.
The Ohio State Boys Championship is on the line.
What's your bet?
For every bounce of the ball. For every shot I've ever taken.
Switch, switch. Pick left.
They're always with me. That's what being there is all about.
People get excited about tomorrow. I love yesterday. Yesterday holds the answers. On a smarter planet, we can compare trillions of pieces of data about the past with what is happening now to help anticipate infectious disease, potential blackouts, when a delivery will arrive. I use the past to predict the future. I'm an IBMer. Let's build a smarter planet.
Welcome back to the UPS Halftime Report.
Guy Laughs, we've got a couple of games Thursday night. I believe that you are heading to Michigan State, right?
Brr, it's cold in East Lansing. Bring the Sherman tank. You work your way into the Izzo, and I'll be there, Ravi.
You like Michigan State late in the season, don't you?
Well, Tom Izzo, great closer. One of the Mario and Riveras of college basketball when it comes to March. The men of March, something to look for as we fill out our brackets.
Temple 57, St. Louis 51. Rhode Island, they're on the bubble, 80-58. Memphis and UAB, they have just started the second half. It's 36-29. Great run at the end of the first half for the Duke Blue Devils, including a three from Shire. Made a one-sided game. Real close. 2 points. Second half coming up.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Toyota. Moving forward.
I just bought a 2010 Toyota Prius.
I am buying a new Toyota Camry.
Brand new 2010 Toyota Camry.
For over 50 years, your loyalty has helped make us the number one car brand in America. So we're offering you our biggest thank you ever. Get no interest payments for 5 years on many of your favorite models. And current Toyota owners, visit Toyota.com for more unprecedented offers.
Thank you for standing by us.
Coldwell?
Yes, banker?
I beefed up security now that we have the J.D. Power and Associates Award.
The locked doors, probably, sir.
Too much?
Coldwell Banker, ranked highest in customer satisfaction.
Introducing Wendy's Bacon and Blue. Hot, juicy North American beef. Real savory blue cheese crumbles. Fresh cooked Applewood smoked bacon. And sautéed onions.
Here you go.
Get your hands on one.
Thanks.
Before somebody else does.
Larry.
Wendy's new Bacon and Blue. Run and get one today.
This Friday, you've got a very important date in Wonderland.
Oh, what the hell?
In Wonderland. Rated PG. Friday.
Hi, I'm Monica Abbott.
The road to success is never easy, and no one gets there on talent alone.
Introducing the K-Factor, a unique system designed to help pitchers take their game to a whole new level. By combining a resistance system with basic pitching drills, the K-Factor focuses on the importance of proper mechanics. Pitchers at all levels will learn to increase arm speed, maximize the length of the arm circle, and strengthen the wrist for better snap. Use the K-Factor as part of your daily workout or during your pregame warm-up. You'll develop healthy muscle memory, build strength and endurance, add overall velocity to pitches, and achieve consistency on the mound. There has never been a tool more valuable for your performance. Order the K-Factor now and start reaching your maximum potential.
Welcome back to College Park, the home of the University of Maryland. You can see it has been a good evening thus far for the Terps, although Duke really got back into it with a run at the end of the first half. This is a good one that could decide top spot in the ACC. Welcome back to the Comcast Center. Dan Shulman to Jay Billis. Glad to have you back with us. A good run. Duke knocked down some threes at the end of the game. How does Maryland get that emotion about Gary Williams talked about?
Yeah, I think they've got to do a better job on the offensive end. When Duke threw that 3-2 or 1-2-2 zone, whatever you want to call it, the odd man front zone, it really took Maryland out of its offensive rhythm. And you know, Maryland had a very good first half. They've still got the lead, but they didn't finish the half the way you need to in order to beat a really good team.
Aaron Andrews got some adjustments that Duke is planning on making. EA?
Yeah, Dan, I talked to assistant coach Chris Collins. He said he felt like the team got back into it in the first half because they took Maryland out of the rhythm and took away the transition game. Key for the second half, the Blue Devils here, guys. Defense and rebounding. Coach Collins saying we are not going to win a shootout against Maryland.
Ryan Zubek is in the game to start the second half. His index finger and middle finger are taped up, dislocated one of his fingers on his left hand late in the first half, but did return to action. Shire bobbles, recovers, knocks down the three, and Duke has its first lead of the night.
Well, you can see why Gary Williams was so concerned about the three-point line for Duke. That's five consecutive threes hit by the Blue Devils.
Vasquez doesn't get the roll. Maryland led by as many as 14 midway through the first half. Duke, of course, used to getting everybody's best shot on the road because it's always a big game when a team like the Blue Devils or the Tar Heels come to town. A couple of missed threes here. Zubek surrounded by Terps and finally fouled. I think it's Jordan Williams. A look at the first half stats. John Shire held to just five. Gravis Vasquez got all seven of his early. Maryland won the battle on the boards, but Duke's three-point shooting and the switch to the zone defense, really the two keys late in the first half.
And the keys for Maryland coming into this game, keeping Duke off the offensive glass and guarding that three-point line. In this second half, so far, that has been hurting Maryland. Duke has gotten offensive rebounds. They got a three to start the second half. And Duke has come out with much more resolve in the second half than in the first.
There's Zubek, who left the game with the dislocated finger midway through the first half, but is back in, a senior who had his best game of his career against Maryland a few weeks ago. All right, let me ask you this. You see all those things behind that you've got to look into and shoot when you're shooting free throws? Is that distracting? Can you avoid looking at all that stuff?
Can you avoid looking at it? Probably not, but you just have to focus on the rim. These guys have done this before. Yeah. Most of these players are veterans. I don't think a few students with funny signs and screaming is going to bother really good players.
Six seniors starting between these two teams. And Vasquez is fouled by Nolan Smith. Earlier tonight in the ACC, there were a couple of games played. Florida State defeating Wake Forest 51-47. And Virginia Tech beat North Carolina State. So Virginia Tech, Florida State, and Clemson all tied for third at 9-6.
Singler switching off on Vasquez, doing a very nice job of staying in front of him.
Vasquez got it.
Much tougher switch when Lance Thomas switched off on Vasquez. Vasquez felt like he could get by him and did.
Does tonight's game go a long way toward determining ACC Player of the Year?
I think it does.
Singler blocks. That was Milburn. But then Maryland gives it back.
Well, what a play by Nolan Smith. That's why you have to catch and face. You can't catch on the run.
And Duke gets the timeout call to retain possession. The block by Melbourne, the loose ball. Nolan Smith hits the deck. Duke will have it when we come back.
First and second round coverage of the Masters, April 8th and 9th on ESPN.
The $5 box, it rocks, it rocks. It rocks for a meal with lots and lots. It rocks for a jock, it rocks for a fox. It rocks blocking shots on guys with dreadlocks.
What comes in this box that rocks?
A cheesy gordita, crunch to much.
We all scream for Burrito Supreme.
A crunchy taco and cinnamon twists?
Both on the list. And wait, let me think, an ice cold drink. That is lots and lots in just one box. It is only $5, and that's why it rocks.
Toyota has done a lot of research and a lot of work. We've been open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and we've made a tremendous amount of progress. You know, safety and reliability is top priority. I mean, I got a family too. I got a mother, a grandmother, kids, and we all drive in these cars. I am 100% confident in the product.
We're grateful to technicians like Ronnie, who are helping us provide you with safe and reliable vehicles. For more information, please visit toyota.com.
When you have sensitive skin, a lot of things can really irritate your face. Shaving shouldn't be one of them. Gillette Fusion Power has 5 blades with an anti-friction coating that shave with incredible comfort. Fusion, proven performance even on sensitive skin.
Real fans know that preparation is the key to success, that dignity should never get in the way of victory. But most of all, real fans know it never hurts to be down with the mascot. Being a real fan has its privileges. Show you're a real fan and root for your favorite team. To find out more, go to ESPN.com/Cheez-It.
To all the happiness and luck that life can hold, and at the end of your rainbow, a pot of gold. Happy St. Paddy's Day from Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness.
Back here in College Park, a tie game 42-42 between Duke, the first-place team of the ACC, Maryland, the second-place team of the ACC. The Blue Devils wrap up the regular season championship with a win. Maryland moves into a tie with Duke if they can win tonight. And, of course, the one of the subplots, arguably the top two candidates for ACC Player of the Year, John Shire, Gravis Vasquez. Anybody else in the mix? Delaney, Malcolm Delaney in the mix, or is it just these two guys?
Malcolm Delaney's had a great year, but I don't think the team has done quite as well as these two teams, and I would certainly give points for that. I think it's between Shire and Vasquez. I would give Shire an edge.
Well, Singler just giving Duke a two-point edge. Shire now coming up with a steal. Smith. Offensive foul.
Well, that's one where you just have to pull up. You want to try to get a little bit closer. That's always what players instinctively want to do. But if you pull up and just bank one off the glass, that's a very good shot.
Mosley taking the charge. Aaron Andrews near the Maryland huddle in the last timeout. EA?
Very passionate, of course, from Gary Williams, but also from Gravis Vasquez as well. They're just talking about being tough, getting the loose ball, guys. And Gary Williams just saying, that's basketball. Just go out there and fight hard.
Well, if Gary Williams could sum things up in one phrase, it might be fight hard. That's what he demands of his players 100% of the time. John Shire, as he does so often, fouled on the three. And you can see by what Gary Williams just did, he is saying that Shire kicked his legs out to initiate the contact, something that Shire, and he's not alone, has been accused of doing at times.
Well, that's what a lot of good shooters do that. Remember that the master of that used to be Colin Falls at Notre Dame. I mean, there was never a three-point shooter fouled as often as Colin Falls, and oftentimes he would kick his leg out.
And of course, putting Shire on the line is pretty much automatic. He is shooting 89% on the season. It really is freakish how often, after you talk about a guy being a great free throw shooter, they miss one. Here's what Shire has to look into, as we talked about before. And he makes 2 of 3.
This is an important period for Maryland to withstand this
surge by Duke, because Duke came out much more resolute in the second half. They have been playing much harder on the defensive end and much harder on the glass.
Maryland once led by 14, so there has been an 18-point turnaround in this game. And currently Duke is on a 17-2 run right now, spanning back into the first half.
And throughout the course of the game, Duke hadn't turned the ball over either. So it's been hard to get extra possessions.
Milburn elevates and misses long. Rebound Zubek.
Zubek, with his size, has really done a great job of being big and staying down low and going to work on the glass on both ends.
He's got 8 rebounds tonight. Smith, no. Loose ball rebound to Vasquez. Remember, early in the game, Jake, too, Maryland was getting all kinds of odd man runouts. 3-on-1s, 4-on-2s. Those have disappeared.
And a lot of that's disappeared because they've been having to take the ball out of the net. You know, Duke's done a much better job of executing on the offensive end.
Freshman Jordan Williams at the line for Maryland. Saturday night, we've got Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV at 9 Eastern here on ESPN. North Carolina and Duke, senior night for John Shire and others at Cameron Indoor Stadium. Before the game, catch Jay and the gang, College Game Day, driven by State Farm at 8 Eastern. With Reese and Hubert and Digger and Coach Knight. Dick Vitale will be there. Aaron will be there. It's going to be a fun night, even though Carolina's not typical Carolina this year. It's still a great rivalry. Carolina, incidentally, has played a little bit better the last couple of games.
They've been competing harder. They really fought Wake Forest on the glass. Beat Miami.
Another strong rebound by Zubek.
And he just went right over the top of Jordan Williams. And Williams asking for an over-the-back foul, but had a great angle on it. Zubek never touched him. He's just bigger.
Zubek 7-1. Williams about 6'9". Smith to Singler. Way long. Zubek another rebound.
And when Zubek gets a rebound, doesn't have an immediate putback, that's where you can really get hurt by a three-point shot.
Double-figure rebounds now for Zubek. And a timeout on the floor. Duke has taken the lead here early in the second half.
On ESPN, number one Syracuse battles Louisville, presented by 5-Hour Energy. Then at 9, North Carolina clashes with 4th-ranked Duke, presented by DirecTV.
Whatever the hell's going on here, it's bad.
Experience the number one movie in America. Shutter Island is unforgettable. It will keep you guessing to the end.
Who knows about this? Everyone.
Shutter Island, rated R. Now playing.
Okay, class. Our special guest is here, Ellen Page.
We're going on a field trip to China.
Wow. When I was a kid, we would just go to the farm. No, seriously, where are you guys going?
The new classroom. See it, live it, share it on the Human Network. Cisco.
I just bought a 2010 Toyota Prius.
I am buying a new Toyota Camry.
Brand new 2010 Toyota Camry.
For over 50 years, your loyalty has helped make us the number one car brand in America. So we're offering you our biggest thank you ever. Get no interest payments for 5 years on many of your favorite models. And current Toyota owners, visit toyota.com for more unprecedented offers.
Thank you for standing by us.
What's the deal with all these people rushing to work, drinking their mochaccinos, cappuccinos, chocolatinos? Take a look at this. The Denny's Meat Lovers Trio. It's one of 3 new dishes for breakfast lovers being served for a limited time. I'd take one of these over a whatever chino any day.
Ryan Zubek, despite an injury, having another big game here against Maryland. He's already got 10 rebounds tonight, five of them at the offensive end. You go back to February the 13th, the 1,000th game that Mike Krzyzewski coached to Duke. It was also his birthday that day. John Shire knocked down three, scored 22 points in the game. Ryan Zubek with the best game of his career, 16 points, 17 rebounds. Duke an easy winner. Steve Wojciechowski said to us at Shootaround today, one of the things he likes about the big guys on his team, and Zubek being one of them, they do what they're supposed to do. They don't try to make moves they're not capable of making and knock down shots they're not capable of making, as Zubek's dad looks on here. They set screens, they rebound, they play defense, they do exactly what they're supposed to do.
Well, they do the dirty work. And you talked about setting screens, and that's exactly what Zubek did just there. And as a screener, he's the guy that got open. And when he screens you and does it right, you stay screened because he's so big.
Closing out his career, playing the best basketball of his career at Duke. Tucker, a couple of baskets early in the first, misses the floater. Back come the Blue Devils, led by Shire.
Zubek got away with a shove there. That's his 11th rebound on the game. He has done yeoman's work on the glass. And one thing Zubek does is now when he establishes low post position, he keeps it. He's not shuffling his feet. He's staying wide, and he's making the easy play. And one thing he probably doesn't get enough credit for, he's a very good passer. He sees the floor pretty well. In the first game, Duke used Zubek a lot to ball screen and parked a couple shooters on the weak side.
Shire finds a cutting Smith. Singler keeps it alive. After getting dominated on the glass early, Duke has now turned the tables, and they are dominating the Terps on the glass. Too many opportunities for the Blue Devils, and finally, a foul going against Duke. But Gary Williams cannot be happy that Duke had four shots on that possession.
Well, Duke is bigger, but they're also outworking Maryland on the offensive glass. Flying at a shooter, and Maryland getting caught a little bit too far underneath. But when the shot went up, it's difficult for Eric Hayes to have to block out a Lance Thomas in there. That's opening up opportunities for guys like Singler. And
Zubek just is able to wedge out anybody trying to box him out. He's just bigger and stronger.
Now this is a different Duke team, a much bigger team than normal. They lead the ACC in rebound margin at about four per game. That foul on Lance Thomas, his third. And Mason Plumlee is going to come in for him at the next opportunity. Maryland, meanwhile, they need a score. They have gone ice cold. Vasquez a miss. Shot clock didn't reset. And it is Duke ball.
Just a bad shot by Vasquez. We had a switch where he had Singler on him, and he pulled the trigger on him. A challenging fall-away jump shot.
Well, you said the first few minutes, first 5 minutes, if you will, the second half would be very important, and Duke having their way with Maryland for the most part.
And it's not been the first shot defense of Maryland that's been the problem. They've done a pretty good job defensively. They're just giving up second, third opportunities, and they're in scramble situations.
Singler, nice look inside. Mason Plumlee foul. Dino Gregory got it.
He does such a good job of keeping the floor spread. Their spacing forces your defense to cover so much ground and help in recover situations.
Into the line goes Mason Plumlee, the younger of the two Plumlee brothers, the freshman, averaging about 4.5 points, 3.5 rebounds per game in 15 minutes per game.
You take a look at the spacing here. Everybody's spaced out, and it's when there's movement and you've got that kind of spacing, you know, Plumlee sets the screen. Everybody worried about Singler as the cutter. When you've got big guys setting screens like that and playing what I call screener scorer basketball, where the screener is looking to score immediately after setting the screen, that is really hard to defend.
Maryland has scored only 4 points in 6 minutes here in the second half, and a wild hook shot by Williams goes.
Just a little duck in on that weak side after the cutter comes through. And anytime you blast off the low side of that low post, that's going to open up what they call the rollback or the duck in. And Jordan Williams, a freshman from Torrington, Connecticut. He's got that wide body, and he likes to post up down low.
And he has tied the game. What an atmosphere here in College Park. Wednesday night hoops on ESPN. Dan Shulman, Jay Billis, Aaron Andrews. Duke, first place in the ACC. Maryland is second place in the ACC. A game back. The Terps led by as many as 14. Here in the first half tonight, trying to snap a six-game losing streak to the Blue Devils. Shire has it rejected. Numbers for Maryland. And Duke comes up with it. It was a 4-on-2 for the Terps, and they couldn't convert.
Duke had three players on the floor on the other end.
Nice crossover by Smith. And he'll get a look from the corner. Maryland pushing. This is Bowie. Vasquez behind the back to a wide open Milburn. In and out.
He doesn't miss those very often. One of the better 15-foot jump shooters in the ACC.
Smith fouled by Bowie.
Duke doing a good job of refusing those ball screens. They've done that twice on this right side. We've seen an opening baseline. Maryland was able to erase the last one with a great shot block.
As a defender, are you just conditioned to think that the ball handler is going to use the ball screen instead of refusing?
Well, not. Maryland wants to force them to use the ball screen, so that's a mistake defensively. You don't want to let your man go away from that ball screen on defense. You want to force him into the screen, so you're forcing him into help.
Vasquez goes to the bench for the Terps. Duke turns it over. Bowie, a lefty, scoops it up and in to get Maryland the lead. Singler. Not this time. Tapped out by Plumlee. And it's going to be an over and back. Shire claiming that ball was deflected by Tucker, but to no avail.
Mike Krzyzewski arguing that there was no possession. And Cliff Tucker may have touched it, but the referee didn't see it that way.
And a good pass. Milburn! The tables have turned here now in favor of Maryland. Shire, tough off-balance leaner.
Shire is so good at playing at his own pace. Now, I've said this about him before. He makes plays on the floor. When other players try to make plays in the air, he keeps his dribble, stays on the floor, and allows the play to develop.
And really took it away from Tucker. Vasquez getting a rest, and Maryland playing well with him on the bench. Taken by Duke. Fear the turtle, one of their favorite sayings here in College Park. And Maryland, after being in kind of a danger zone for a while, Jay, they have really responded.
And Duke is switching screens out on the perimeter. That meant that Mason Plumlee switched out on Adrian Bowie. And Bowie is a driver, not the type of guy you expect to just step back, dribble, and drill one from three-point range. But when he saw the freshman Plumlee switch off on him, he did not hesitate to pull that trigger.
pretty tough-minded group of Terrapins here tonight. Bowie, a 32% three-point shooter, just making his first attempt of the evening. So much on the line, so much emotion, such a heated rivalry. And Vasquez continues to get a rest on the bench for Maryland.
And Kerry Williams getting great minutes off of his bench. Bowie's come in and done a nice job for him, as has Dino Gregory.
Singler with the quick release. Rebound Thomas.
Maryland just giving Duke so many second chances.
Shire travels. Mike Krzyzewski furious.
Boy, he had two dribbles before he called that thing.
Timeout on the floor. Midway through the second half. Maryland by five.
If you want directions to the stadium, push here. If you want to see the weather ahead, push here. If you want to access 10 gigs of music you just downloaded to your hard drive, push here. And if you want to pull away from it all, you can push here. The all-new 40-gig hard drive nav and entertainment system on the 2010 LaCrosse from Buick. It's the new class of world class.
The biggest stage creates the biggest drama this summer. Live from South Africa, the 2010 FIFA World Cup on ESPN, coming in June.
Tonight on SportsCenter, KU, K-State will play in Kansas, the conference, and possibly a number one seed. Our experts pick the national champion, who's ready for a title run, plus Durant and Melo in a Wild West shootout. SportsCenter after the game.
Premiering this weekend on DirecTV Cinema.
Got a pretty mouth.
Welcome to Zombieland. We're one of the few non-zombies left.
That is so offensive.
Look alive.
Time to put up or shut up.
Or you're dead.
What do you think? Zombie kill of the week?
Zombieland.
Movies playing on channels 125 through 199. DirecTV Cinema brings you the 2010 Academy Awards nominees.
I assume you know who we are.
Well, yeah.
Enjoy your own private screening leading up to Hollywood's biggest night.
Really?
Riveting performances.
You threaten my son. You threaten me.
Now smile about that. Nobody loves me.
The year's best filmmaking.
That's what they call a suicide bomb, right?
The movies you want to watch are playing on DirecTV Cinema. Channels 125 through 199.
That's fantastic.
Back at College Park, a five-point lead for Maryland over Duke. Another look at the play just before the timeout that infuriated Mike Krzyzewski.
Yeah, after the offensive rebound, a little handoff by Lance Thomas, and there was no walk there. And I was a little surprised. Les Jones called that walk after about the second dribble that John Shire had. It was clear that there was no walk there.
How about out of the timeout, Gravis Vasquez remains on the bench. As you said, great play from Adrian Abui and the Maryland bench. And Vasquez, the star for the Terps, remains on the bench right now. A turnover. And it has not been a vintage night for Vasquez tonight. He's got 9 points, four assists.
And Maryland very fortunate there, leaving a three-point shooter wide open.
Bowie to Tucker, who tried to reverse it. Had he gone straight up, he might have just drawn the foul, but instead opted for the spectacular play and came up empty. And now Vasquez, now he stood up and he sits back down. Jordan Williams will check in for Maryland.
Well, you make a great point about Milburn. He needed to go up and draw that foul. Seek out the contact instead of avoiding it.
Smith turns the corner. Good defense, good recovery by Bowie, and Smith makes a very tough shot.
Well, that was good defense by Bowie. The first thing he did was he ran Nolan Smith off the three-point line and forced him to curl, and he forced Smith to make a really tough shot.
Open is Mosley. Rebound Shire. The big three for Duke have 38 of their 51 points. That's fairly typical for the Blue Devils this season. They average over 53 points per game, the threesome.
Well, this game is going to come down to toughness plays like that one.
You don't usually see a lot of emotion from Nolan Smith, but you saw some right there.
Here you can see Nolan Smith being chased off that three-point line by Bowie, and Bowie stays between him and the basket. He just makes a really difficult shot. And talk about a difficult shot. The spin move to get the angle. And Nolan Smith seeks out that contact, goes right into the chest of Sean Mosley.
Vasquez has returned, as has Hayes, who has been quiet here for the second half after a great start to the game. And five consecutive points for Nolan Smith have tied the game.
Boy, Nolan Smith has done it on both ends. He has defended Vasquez very well.
Remember, Vasquez averaging better than 24 a game his last eight, only nine tonight. A turnover on the entry pass. Krzyzewski calls out a play and wants the ball in the hands of Shire.
Well, that way he can get Shire to work off the ball and let Smith take on Hayes.
And the foul before the shot. No basket as Smith draws another foul.
And one thing Mike Krzyzewski has done over the years, especially since he started working with the Olympic team and working with so many NBA players, is he is spending more time going after good matchups. If he gets a good matchup, he'll go to a hot hand. Smith has had the hot hand for them in this game.
Misses the front end, though. Smith, a very good free throw shooter, but a break there for Maryland, and now a foul at the other end. Lance Thomas, I believe. And if it's Thomas, it's his fourth. And now Thomas will come out. Andre Dawkins will check in, Duke. This is the first time, Jay, this is the first time tonight we've seen Duke go to a smaller lineup with Singler going back to the four.
Singler, a tough matchup at the four, but it does take away a little bit of a rebounding advantage. Nice play by Williams.
Singler stood him up defensively, no call, and they play on.
A little fake handoff and then taking it to the rim. That's a play that, as he gets older, I think he'll finish more often.
Vasquez denying Shire the ball. Hayes on Smith, Vasquez on Shire.
Pick and pop out top, well defended.
Smith inside, likes the teardrop, gets it to go. Nolan Smith with so many big moments here in the second half.
They defended the high screen going one way. And Duke just turned around and went right back at it.
Smith has the last 7 points for Duke. And he has given the Duke Blue Devils a 2-point lead on Maryland. We're in the final week of regular season play around the country. And a look at the top half of the ACC. Duke at 12-2, Maryland 11-3. They've already clinched the top two spots. If Duke wins tonight, they'll win the regular season championship outright. If Maryland wins tonight, they'll move into a tie. If the two teams finish in a tie, Duke would win the tiebreaker to be the number one seed of the ACC tournament in Greensboro. But they would both earn the honor of hanging a regular season championship banner.
Calling himself ACC champion has always been a really important endeavor in this league. And Nolan Smith, he's just had a great year. He has stepped forward in this game and really taken on the challenge, both on the offensive end when his team has had a problem scoring, and in the defensive end guarding one of the best offensive players in the league in Brevis Vasquez.
We got fouled, and it's Smith called for the foul. Vasquez will shoot a pair. Smith didn't like the call at all. The under eight media timeout is upon us. A 2-point lead for the Blue Devils here in College Park.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by GMC. We are professional grade.
There are 31 days in GMC's truck month. Make each one count. With a truck that offers you over 300 horsepower, over 1,800 pounds of payload, and over 20 highway miles per gallon. Get 0% APR for 60 months on Sierra Half Ton. Rated a Consumer's Digest Best Buy. If you've got work to do, Truck Month couldn't have come at a better time.
Hi, may I help you?
Yes, we're looking to save on car insurance, even if that means we have to shop all day, right, honey?
Yep, all day.
Good thing you're starting here. We compare your Progressive direct rate to other top companies,
so you can save money.
Look. You saved a lot.
And quick, too.
And no more holding her purse.
It's a European shoulder bag.
It was a gift.
Shopping less and saving more. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
I'm from the union. I can pay. That's not my department.
Their job was to repossess organs.
Pretty impressive, boys.
Until he needed one.
No time at all. You're going to be back on your game. You're going to be knocking them dead.
On March 19th.
I'm falling behind on payment.
Everyone wants a piece of him.
Now he's yours.
What do you want to do?
Finish this.
Repo Man. Rated R. In theaters March 19th.
SportsCenter will follow our game with the highlights of all the college hoop. Kansas tonight a winner. Senior night there. They beat them 82-65. Sherrod Collins goes out a winner. 17 points. He's got more wins in 4 years than any player in Kansas history. And Kentucky a winner. 80-68 over Georgia. John Wall. Defense leads to offense. He had 24. Again, SportsCenter after the game. ESPN News for the highlights always.
Carl, thank you. Back here in College Park, you're looking at the top two teams of the ACC. First place Duke, second place Maryland. A two-point game here on senior night for Gravis, Vasquez, and others. A look at the upcoming ACC tournament at Greensboro. If the tournament were to begin right now, here's how they would line up with Duke, Maryland, Clemson, and Virginia Tech getting the first round bye. So much could change in the next week. Give me a dark horse, Jay. Who jumps out at
you? I would say Virginia Tech. They not only have one of the leading scorers in the country and Malcolm Delaney, but Jeff Allen is a really talented player. That's an athletic group, and I think they could be dangerous on a neutral court if they get some momentum.
Didn't have much of a non-conference schedule, but they have more than made up for it with an impressive run within the ACC. And again, if you're a bracketologist or a fan of bracketology, heading into tonight, Joe Lunardi had 7 ACC teams in the tournament. Virginia Tech was one of his last 4 in. I believe Notre Dame was his first team out, but that was prior to play tonight. And, of course, Notre Dame won again. Again without Luke Perigotti. They beat UConn at home tonight. Very low score game.
Well, Duke has had some wide open looks from three.
Ooh, and stops on a dime.
And when Duke has missed open threes, that's given Maryland an opportunity to run out. And neither team has shot the ball well in the second half. That's why I think this game is going to come down to who's tougher on the glass when the ball's loose, who's getting down and going after it.
And Maryland has now gone small as well, with Mosley effectively playing the power forward spot, guarding senior. Andre Dawkins knocks down a shot.
He just has a great stroke. Near perfect form, just an 18-year-old kid that graduated high school early to play on this team.
Vasquez has it rejected. I think it was Singler. And back come the Blue Devils with the ball and the lead. Singler on the drive and draws the foul.
A really good use of the shot fake by Kyle Singler. Got his defender to lift up just a bit, gave up a middle drive. Mosley's done a pretty darn good job of staying low. And on this closeout, Maryland teaches their players to fly at shooters, but they certainly don't do it when a guy's got his dribble.
Gary Williams will use a 30-second timeout. Well, we talked about the big picture and coming into the night. According to our bracketologist, Joe Lunardi, who were the last 4 in and the first 4 out. Virginia Tech was one of his last 4 in, but as we mentioned a little bit earlier, Virginia Tech won tonight. They beat North Carolina State. Notre Dame was one of his first 4 out. Notre Dame won tonight, beat UConn, and so many things are going to change. And you say this is one of the years where the bubble-type teams are weaker than normal, that instead of maybe there being some deserving teams who won't get in, they might struggle to find 34 quality at large teams.
I think some of these teams with the resumes that they're putting out there at this stage of the season in years past wouldn't have gotten a sniff of the NCAA tournament. This is just a different year. I don't think there's a truly great team out there. And I think it's the weakest pool of at-large teams we've seen since the field went to 64. But what we're going to see as a result is one of the most exciting NCAA tournaments. I think a lot of these teams, and we're looking at
a couple of them right now, but especially Duke. I think Duke is the better of these two teams over the long haul. If you're playing well going into the NCAA tournament, you really have to feel like you've got a chance to win this whole thing. It reminds me of 2006 when Florida won the first of back-to-back titles, and the teams that made up the Final Four, very few people would have picked those four. In fact, none did.
Well, you look at Syracuse, which is right now ranked number one. They were unranked at the beginning of the season and have ascended all the way to the number one spot.
Maryland into its flex there.
Mosley, nice look off to Hayes, and it's tied.
How many great cuts have we seen in this game made by that young man, Eric Hayes? He is one of the best cutters, not only in the ACC, but in the country that I've seen this year.
Remember, Hayes is also playing his last home game. Senior night for him, Landon Milbourne as well. Duke will be in the same situation Saturday night at home against Carolina. Shire with an off-balance three.
Vasquez ran right into Brian Zubek. That was a great screen by the seven-footer. Flex offense along that baseline can be very hard to guard.
Into the hands of Vasquez. Plenty of time to shoot. He'll launch a three. That ties it. He's got his parents here, his high school coach here, the Maryland star trying to end his home career with a win. Shire can't get the shot off over Vasquez. Left-hand scoop, yes!
Oh, what a shot. Brian Zubek did a nice job when he caught that little lob pass from Singler of motioning to his teammates to move. They were standing around, and his motion of his head got them moving.
Shire now with 17. Mosley. Rebound, Bowie. He has been huge for the Terps tonight. 9 points, hasn't missed a shot.
Here comes Zubek.
Shire looking for the...